Hey guys, back in the clean room, this time with a Model Y. We've only done about 4 million of these, so kind of getting there, understanding it. More EVs with difficult to clean wheels. Fortunately, EVs don't put out as much brake dust usually, especially if they're driving them, taking advantage of regen. I drive an EV every day and have for years. You get used to virtually not touching the brakes most days. Not sure if you can see that, but there is just there the hologram. Fairly typical on most new cars, especially Tesla. Actually pretty good. Yet to prepare the car, and once I wash and strip whatever coatings it may have off, you may see more imperfections, but this does look pretty good. It is presented fairly well. Tesla, although they are, I would still put them at the bottom of the pack for new vehicle presentation, they are consistently improving. A couple more very minor holograms on the bonnet. There should be a piece of cake to work on, and it should look lovely after it's prepared. Washing, just got to get under the wiper arm and just lift the wiper up. Love it. That's how you make a car easier to use and more enjoyable. Okay, we're all washed up. Now we can see our imperfections a little easier. What I am noticing, apart from, I have to be careful of these lips here, Tesla, I rarely see a headlight that runs flush with the body. I'm starting to think that perhaps they're not designed that way. They do meet here, but here they are significantly higher. There's a lip there, and that'll catch a machine. You're unlikely to hurt the edge of the headlight, but putting significant wear there, you can remove the coating and the polycarbonate. You don't want to do that. But a little bit of, not sure if you can see it, a little bit of white polish stuck in there, and it's actually very hard. May have been there for a little while. Wet polishing the door handles, under the trim here, all along the trim here. Might find it very difficult. Let's see if I can focus. Can you see that white trim? That white polish in the trim. This isn't too bad. What's happened here? That doesn't look good. That's either white polish in the trim there, or they've taken some of the black anodizing or black paint off. I hope, for the customer's sake, that's just polish. It looks like just a whole bunch of polish jammed and hardened in that trim there. It's not the best pre-delivery detail. We've also got a scuff, again, very, very difficult to see, but right here we've got a scuff. It's a semicircular shape, so it looks like what's happened is a buffing pad has been used. Very difficult to see on my screen anyway, so I don't think I'm able to visualize it for you. This is not focusing properly, but there's a semicircle here. So someone's used the buffing pad and it's come up and over, and they haven't masked this trim, and it's done some damage. Because that's matte, when you polish it, it comes up glossy. And this is also a touch white. More polish here. This one's really obvious in the charger cap. Fortunately, this lifts up and out of the way, so that should be fairly easy to clean. Oh my god, there's so much white hardened polish everywhere. I can see at least an hour added to the job. There's polish in every crevice on this vehicle. But it is very, very clean, very neat, and the imperfections in the paintwork are very few and far between, and also very quick and easy to remove. Actually, I think I may spend more time removing polish from gaps than, what was that hologram I saw before? Just double checking, yeah, definitely it's a hologram, wasn't anything sitting on top of the paintwork. So that rear door needs to be corrected again. Very strange that there's correction still to be done, but correction was done and done poorly. It may as well not have done it at all and saved doing the damage on the trim there. Right, we'll get this corrected. Be a breeze, no problem at all. Tesla's got very soft paintwork. It comes up very quickly. Should be no issue whatsoever. These marks here, right here, if it would focus, come on. These marks here, these dots you can see here, looks like etching. It's actually not a watermark etching, a water evaporating on the surface and mineral etching. It's bird droppings. Some of you may be able to tell by the shape. Try to correct this, no go. You can see it even from this distance. Actually, probably a better idea. You get a better idea of the shape. You can see where it's landed and dripped. And then it's dried. And the chemical reaction has caused that etching in the clear coat, which is permanent. This is also why, a very good example of why you should apply your paint protection on your new car ASAP.